Onorevole Ministro del Lavoro del Brasile, distinguished participants, sisters and brothers. Child labor is prohibited within the European Union, but in fact, a grim picture emerges when we look at it in many European states. The Human Rights Commissioner of the Council of Europe has launched very recent alarms on this phenomenon, and documented evidence from authoritative sources shows that many of those children who work in Europe have extremely hazardous occupations in agriculture, construction, small factories, or on the street. Indeed, countries such as Cyprus, Greece, Italy, and Portugal have been heavily affected by austerity measures undertaken by their governments, taking crisis as a pretext. Those decisions are having a dramatic impact, especially on vulnerable groups, children first, both through the reduction of family incomes and support and through budgetary cuts in state social expenditures. Data from Eurostat highlight that in 2011, children in Europe were at greater risk of poverty or social exclusion than the rest of the population. 27% of children faced that risk. Even though EU member states should primarily take measures addressing cases of malnutrition, in contradiction with that need, budgetary cuts are affecting services for children, including healthcare, education, social services. I want to take the example of my country, Italy. In Italy, austerity measures have caused further obstacles to growth, and it must be remarked that public administration and public spending were already below the EU average. The Italian Society of Pediatrics and the major children's medical networks raised concern over the impact of budgetary cuts in the social and health care sectors. The president of the Authority for Childhood said that almost 2 million children were living in families in poverty in Italy, drawing on data published by the National Statistical Office. On June 2013, a survey from the Research Institute of CGIL, together with Save the Children, point out that in Italy at least one out of 20 children is exploited. Nobody can then be surprised if Italy finds itself amongst the first positions in Europe as of school dropping out, as 18% while the European average is 14, and as poverty expansion, which are two sides of the same coin. The costs of dropping out of school in Italy are apparently invisible, but in fact they are very high also in economic terms, amounting to about 70 billion of euro per year. On October 2011, the concluding observations of the UN Committee on the Rights of the Child asked Italy, amongst many other relevant demands, to adopt national standards such as the essential levels for the provision of social services. On 2013, CGIL drafted an extraordinary plan for jobs, stressing the need of a great cultural revolution on many aspects. Two major of them are the value of education and training on one side and the quality of work on the other, especially in the age of temporary, clandestine, underpaid work or of work at any cost. Under any condition, it is essential to define decent work anew as it is a necessary component of a concept of development. Here are the demands of the Italian trade unions to the government authorities at any level. Raising the compulsory schooling period, leading an efficient fight against the school dropout, getting a lifelong learning system, setting a policy for the right to study that increases enrollments in the universities and the number of graduates, and ensuring an actual free universal education, especially in the first compulsory classes. Those demands go together with the adoption of a national plan on child labor on a tripartite structure. Throughout Europe, Roma children are especially at risk. Roma continue to face discrimination and social exclusion, with many living in deep poverty and lacking access to health care and decent housing. Vulnerable as well are unaccompanied migrants under 18 and children of migrants originating from developing countries. Almost one out of three asylum seekers arriving in the EU in 2012 was a child, And there is a concern that their protection remains a challenge, especially looking at the last tragedy in Lampedusa, which shows the evident failure of the existing policies on migration, a shame for all of us. We strongly believe that those considerations should be here at the forefront of the international community and the EU policy debate, in order to finally break the chain of decent work deficit, poverty, inequality and disadvantage. Thank you for your attention. Grazie, obrigada.
Obrigado.